This episode is all about motion track, also known as the active track killer. Want to learn some tips for motion tracking with your Skydio 2? Well, good, because we're going to teach you some tips for motion tracking with your Skydio 2. Motion tracking is Skydio 2's default form of subject tracking, and it can be performed using your phone, beacon, or controller. Motion tracking means that Skydio 2 will maintain both its position and orientation relative to the subject as it moves. This means the more the subject changes direction, the more Skydio 2 will move to keep its position. There are several different ways to initiate the motion tracking skill. The easiest way to begin motion tracking is by performing a hand launch. Skydio 2 will take off and then automatically turn around and begin motion tracking you. To learn more about hand launching, check out our launching and landing episode or our support page. This technique will work whether you are using your phone or your beacon. But if flying with the controller, Skydio 2 will not turn around and lock on. If Skydio 2 is already in the air, you can begin motion tracking in the following ways. Initiate motion tracking from the app by tapping the blue plus button over the subject you want to track. Or begin motion tracking from the beacon by pointing Skydio 2's camera at the subject you want to track. Then select motion track from the cinematic mode selector and press the blue Skydio button. Skydio 2 uses your motion to predict the orientation of its subject. If you are standing still when you initiate motion tracking, Skydio 2 may not be able to position itself in the right orientation. Begin moving and Skydio 2 will fly to the selected position. Once you have initiated motion tracking, you can use the app to change the orientation of Skydio 2 by using the compass icon. You can change the tracking distance of Skydio 2 using the plus minus buttons. Increasing this range means Skydio 2 will move both up and away in order to keep its angle of filming consistent relative to you. Once Skydio 2 is at the desired tracking distance, use the height adjustment to set up a low or high angle shot. Adjusting the height before you begin your activity is also a good way to keep Skydio 2 away from potential obstacles. If you are using the beacon, use the arrow buttons to adjust the orientation and the plus minus buttons to adjust tracking distance. If you want to quickly adjust tracking orientation and height, try using drag and drop. To use drag and drop, point the beacon at Skydio 2 and press and hold the blue Skydio button, then point where you want Skydio 2 positioned and release the blue Skydio button. Drag and drop is the best way to adjust the height of Skydio 2 while maintaining a set tracking distance. Skydio 2 will always prioritize avoiding obstacles and maintaining tracking over staying in the selected position, but it will return to the desired position once it has room to do so safely. You can disable the height floor to allow for even better motion tracking, but we only recommend doing this in areas clear of people, animals, and other moving objects. Motion tracking is a great option for activities that have a relatively consistent direction of motion or take place at slower speeds and can produce incredibly dynamic shots as Skydio 2 repositions itself. If you are doing a faster speed activity, motion tracking will be most reliable while tracking from behind, so Skydio 2 can keep you in frame. Motion tracking will work on vehicles, but remember, you should never fly above public roads. And that, dear Skydians, is the story of the active track killer. We're gonna teach you some trips. By tapping the blue pus. But it will return to the desired and can produce incredible, and can produce.
I love it.